Hey, it's Dark91G, and welcome back to Galaxy on Fire 2. The video description is advised, hope you enjoyed. Now, today, let's do a little flip. Woo! So I can actually see cargo. We're still trying to get off this foreboding place. But, eventually we will get, to the part where all of the people like mods are mine. But I'm not mine to make anyone right now. I just wanted to get for the station. You should, like, when you jump for station, talk for some people in the lounge. You don't accept any of the jobs if you want to get out of here quickly, because we already have some money from selling a minigun. And bought a new one. Holding more than 50 tons of free cargo space. Good to know. Does that mean I have to, like, have the Rhino to actually make this? So there are some ships. I do want Rhino, Dark Angel, and then there's this orange one called the Kern. Kanurka or something like that, Kazaka or something like that. I don't know, I can't pronounce it really well. I'll have to look up the name of it. But yeah, that's what it's called. And so we'll go to here. It'll say how it works basically.
Greetings.
So you just tap around.
You look like a tough guy.
How about a little bit?
Straightforward assignment.
This thing's not really built for combat. I'm looking for the one that you can destroy all the trash, because that's the easiest one to do. And you only get like one pirate in it. But we'll fly around, see what we get. Now this is a risky system. But I haven't seen any problems yet.
It's a straightforward assignment.
You can hold up to 25 cargo. Oh yeah, we can do that.
It's a straightforward assignment.
Show me on the map. Okay. What are the wrists? Let's go. That's the problem right there. It costs to do this one. So, no pirates, good. Let's go to the asteroid field for a little bit and make a little bit of money so that we can do this. The reason why it costs money to do this part is because, we're in extreme mode, and with extreme mode, a lot of missions are going to cost money to do, so that's going to be fun. We'll just make like about the 200 we need. But yeah, this drill is slightly harder to control. It likes to jolt randomly. But yeah, it likes jolting around, something like that. And it's not a bad drill if you know how to control it. You gotta keep it moving constantly. Now there is a little, you see I'm going in the red, there's a reason for that, because sometimes you don't get all of it. Yes. I know. When your cargo's full, you pull to return. I know that. But yeah, we're going to make a little bit of money. And then we're going to start the mission. I'm not going to sell the main gun thing because we need that for the glitch. And that's the best way to make money. Wow. So, like, bam. We got all that money that we used back. Now, what you always do when you do this is you sell it at the station. You do that really quickly so that you can save it. Just in case, like, something bad happens, you have to go through that entire process all over again. And as you can see, there's lots of money in these. We'll get to that, this episode, hopefully. But yeah, it's gonna be fun. So, now we can do that.
Greetings. It's a straightforward assignment.
No, that's people.
I could use a hand. It's a straightforward assignment.
And the thing is, if you're trying to backstab him and sell off, you can't. See? Bam, you can't sell it. So. And if you see, that's like, it looked pinkish red to me because I'm colorblind. but one pirate's gonna chase me. Oh no! Screw up, buddy. Get your own crap. But yeah, just... Ooh, none here. I forgot what I was saying, but yeah, as you saw there, you can't backstab and say, oh, they're gonna try to transport something really good, and we can sell it.
Mr. Maxwell!
And I forgot to turn down the desktop recording, so you might hear a little bit of record audio blipping in and out, because I forgot to, when I was playing around, I forgot to turn off the desktop audio. So, sorry about that for a little bit, but now it should be fixed. So, where is it at? You there? Okay, I'm just gonna... So it saves the money. And then we have 4,000. Now, it is somewhat, like... If you want to grind all you want, you can grind all you want on this stuff, but... I've played this long enough to get bored of that, so... We're gonna go and... do the glitch. Now there are pirates here. I am not scared of them right now, because I know that where we're going, we don't have to worry about them, except for now. Here we go. I wish I had 2 weapons left.
Ah, there's the convoy, and it looks like pirates are closing in on it. I'd better intercept them.
Boom, give me a pirate. Ooh, there are 3. Now I might die here, depending on how this favors out for me.
There, another pirate ship. Ready the EMP blaster.
Look at this piece of crap. Ow. Yep, and we died. So welcome to the first death of the series. The reason why I died is because I should have stayed back a little bit and let them fight. Unless I wasn't dodging. So what we'll do happens in the... This is a perfect time to explain this, and here it is. Tap to go back to the same grade, that's why you save it with the money. I should have gone... Which also is the thing you have to take account. The weapon I chose had the highest damage, but I have to be close. One thing that Galaxy on Fire 2 doesn't have, a gun that's like a shotgun.
Ah, there's a convoy.
Yeah, we already heard this. So as you can see, he has at 95%. We're gonna confront him and see how he's going.
There, another pirate ship. Ready the EMP blaster.
Stay with me. You can just do that. There's too many of them here. Try not to get hit, but the stupid AI is smarter in this mode. Just to dodge. Let them duke it out. It's not the fastest way, but it's a way.
Mr.
supposed to do is supposed to either wait them out their fight, or you're gonna help them, but you're supposed to help them, but trying, but it's not doing so well. Like that, brother. Even touch me. What the heck? Oh, I hate that. The swiping nicks that view. Can we even dodge that? Dodge me. I'll be back when I do this correctly. So, as you saw, we got our ass pretty much kicked, so. Let's do what's in the hangar. So I think what I need is either a better weapon, or I need a shield. Because that's mostly my problem. Now, for some odd reason, I think because I chose the machine gun, I'm having issues. I usually choose the one that has the longest range. There we go. Shield generator. Boom. This also might be essential because it'll increase your mobility. The problem is, as you can see, you already ran into a problem of not having enough equipment area. I would sell the drill, but I don't think we should. That's the one thing. Let's save. Now let's try it. Don't know why it's being a pain in the butt. Usually, it's not that hard. You just go in there, shoot three guys, and you're done. But what then? Hopefully this will be enough to beat the crap out of them. I got a little annoyed there, so I had to take some time and figure out what I need to do better.
There, another pirate ship. Ready and the shield blaster.
Is the perfect thing because it will recharge over time. And see, look at that. Boom, recharge over time. If that's what you're supposed to do, that'd be my advice. It's way more easier to do that. And actually, I'm open to check. So the shield is definitely useful in this part of the mission, this part of the start line, because it's one of those only things that can recharge for you right now. So, yeah. Like this time around, they're not on top of it. I try to focus on one at a time. Be smart like that. So the cool thing with the shield is that you can take some hits.
Third
health bar.
Hey! Why are you idiots shooting me? I'm trying to help you.
Yeah, exactly my point.
Surrender! Your ship has been disabled and you're under arrest. Prepare to have your ship impounded.
Actually, he's
taken aboard a cruiser heading for the planet Aliot in Terran space.
Hold up, I feel like the music is a little loud. That's probably why I turned it down a while back.
On Aliot station, Keith is being interrogated by Lieutenant Commander Brent Snowcock.
And that's why we thought you were a pirate. It's a surprise to see you alive. You were declared dead a long time ago.
As you can see, my death was a bit of an exaggeration. A malfunction in my hyperdrive pulled me through time and space.
Incredible. And then you got stranded in the Mito system, eh?
Took me some time to get back on my feet again. I was hoping to get back to Terran territory. Not as a prisoner, though.
Sorry for the inconvenience. I can imagine that Mito must have been rough for you. The whole system was only settled a few years ago, and the inhabitants are really struggling to make ends meet.
Brent, Since when do you care about rebels and outlaws? I thought you were a security officer.
Well, that was some time ago, Keith. Now I'm Lieutenant Commander, Chief of the Interstellar Security Agency. Among other things, I'm responsible for...
Alert! Void fighters located in an alien orbit. All hands to battle stations. All hands to battle stations.
What's happening?
What the... I never expected them to come here, too. I'll explain later. Prepare your ship!
So yeah, we're being attacked by the Void. As you can see, there's other ships coming by, but we're not getting those because we can't buy them. So we need some guiding missiles, bro. Which I should have put on my ship in the first place. We'll buy the armor, but meh, we don't have the money or the time to do it.
Keith, this is Brent. The Void ships are attacking our freighters. We need to defend them. All right, I have them on my screen. Let's see what they've got.
Which is everything they have, because we lose the ships anyways. Before we even get there. Yep, see?
Interesting way of saying hello.
It is indeed. And they're gone. Keep your mind, your scanner. I don't think they can shoot from that far. Oh! Yeah. We're gonna see more of those when we do the mission episode. Come to this dude. Whoa, excuse me. Clear. Yeah.
Follow them. Don't let them get away. Too late. They disappeared.
Am I gonna go in there?
Damn it. Good. They've taken the whole shipment. Another attack like that and we'll have to close down the station. How long has this been going on? Let's head back first. I'll give you a full briefing at the station.
Okay, that's pretty interesting. So, yeah. I'm like, what's in my cargo hold? The laser.
So after that, I had to marry her. The surgery looked great, but eventually I realized...
No offense, Brent, but can you stick to the story, please?
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Anyway, you've seen the problem we're dealing with. These Voids are a real pest. They have the technology to open up wormholes and jump anywhere they like. Their tactic is always the same, hit and run. They jump in through their wormhole, attack freighters, take the cargo, and jump back out.
Any idea where they're coming from?
Unfortunately, we haven't been able to pinpoint where the wormholes lead.
So you can't detect where or when they're going to attack?
Exactly. They're extremely unpredictable. As head of security, I've been placed in command of a crisis team tasked with finding a solution. Our best scientists are working on countermeasures at the Deep Science Research Station. If you're interested, they're still hiring experienced pilots. You'd receive adequate compensation.
I could use the money, but babysitting scientists?
Well, not quite. For the exact job description, you better talk to Lieutenant Boyle, a scientist traveling to Deep Science.
Thanks, Brent. I'll look him up when I get there.
Without Boyle's navigation data, you won't find the system where the station is located. It's top secret and isn't listed on standard star maps.
That's quite some security you have there. How can I get in touch with him then?
He's expected at Sutner Station in the Union system before traveling to Deep Science. You should meet him there.
Sounds like a plan. Thanks for your help.
No problem, Keith. I'll tell Boyle to expect you. We'll talk later. Bye.
So So yeah, we're gonna use jump gates to get there. But we're not going there yet. Really? There's like a little spot you have to go to. Yeah, there. We're gonna completely avoid that. And we're gonna go for this. I know. That's the place we gotta go. We're gonna jump from here to here. Because it's average. And we might die a lot. So you might see that in the time lapse. But we're gonna... we're gonna do that. So do I have a jump gate here? Adios, bro. So yeah, I also will disable my scanner so that I can easily go in and out fast. So if you don't have a scanning device, you do not see those green and other dots. So it makes it so you don't see them whatsoever. So you can jump in. And I'm jumping with this thing. Nice. Except for I go faster. Then we go for a jump gate again. Now here's the maneuvering part we have to do.
A lot of pirate activity here. Okay. Strange.
Really? This is why I would activate the disable the scanner. Just for this reason, because you see how long it's taking us to get to the jump gate. I'll make it so, as you can see, we're taking some shield damage, but because of the shield, we'll have a longer time, and it regens slowly. So we'll have a longer time to, until we have to worry about it. That's the reason why I got it back there, because I kept on having issues of dying without... So its shield is technically required. Well, I guess we'll eventually go to here, because, you have to pay him a small fee, but because of the cargo hold, I can't do that. Because they charge you for how much a 20% from your cargo hold. Now here's the station. Now if you came here without buying into it, there'd be pirate things all over the place. And this club is owned by Muktabuk. Unless you either get the Buscat and the money, or you get the thing. So yeah, this is your place. You can put whatever you want in this place. So how the glitch works is that you put both these in, you go out of the hangar, go out in here, grab them, equip one, and just for our safety measures, you go back into the station and you save. Because if you have you may have a slight chance of dying. So then we're gonna go to the place that has the jump gate. And this is the hardest part until you get the cattle drive, is that you have to go to for jump gates, which is useful for the jump gate achievement. Zap. So after I do this once and show you how the glitch works, I will time lapse this out. And as you see, oh yeah, I forgot to deactivate the scanner.
They must have built an outpost somewhere.
But yeah, really? You think? As you see, I'm taking a lot of damage. I'll do some dodging here and there, but that's just for giving me a little extra time for the shield regen. And so, now it's hitting the armor. If you dodge a little bit more, you get that little extra shield. But yeah, these pirates are a big pain in the butt. Especially if there's like five of them. But yeah, you don't have to worry about dodging until you're like half health. As you can see here, I'm just swinging back and forth. That's the only danger of this place. But what you do is, eventually you want to get something with higher cargo, like this thing. And it has, higher everything. Which actually, all these are pretty good. That's 4. That's 5. That's 11. That's actually not that bad. That's 8. 8. So I would go for this mainly, but this is the one thing I might go for. It's a nice one, but We might have to settle with this one eventually. But yeah, we'll go slowly go for the week, so we'll get this next. And we'll just go up. And we'll get this. Then just go up slowly for the line. Now when you're here, you gotta deactivate this. You gotta sell until you have one. And then you equip it. And then we go back. Hey, look at this. Woo! We don't have to worry about, this makes it way faster. And as you see, they'll hit me once in a while, my shield will go down, or my armor. But that's not the problem. Yes, jump, get back to my stove shore. So, I'll start doing a time-lapse soon, and, yeah, it'll just be a very, like, the fastest ship stuff you'll ever see in this game. Mostly the reason why I time-lapse it, because this will probably take me about 20 to 30 minutes to do, to get some decent amount of money. So, yeah. So after you unequip it, bam, look it, a free extra gun. Now you'd be saying, but this is cheating. Nah, I don't classify it as cheating. I classify it as a glitch in the game that developers left behind because they don't give a crap about it. And so it hasn't been patched because this game's been neglected. So if they neglected it, I don't count it as a cheat. It's just something that the game developer was like, meh. It happened and happened. And I saw there on that one system, it had a check mark on the one with my station. That tells you I've explored every station in this planet, which there's only one state on the system, which is only one. Now, I also bought the thing that makes the ships cheaper, so that one ship that was like 2 mil would actually be 3 mil. So, as you see now, we're at half health. This is the part where you might die at. And as you can see with the stupid game. And we're dead. So that's the risk with this place, because there's so many stupid pirates. I don't know why they put this many in one spot. There's supposed to be a hideout. I'm supposed to blow up somewhere. But shut up, game, and give me my stupid tap. Give me the tap. That's the one part I don't like. Now, because I saved, it still has the glitch on it. So if you didn't save, and you didn't get the gun in your ship, then you're going to have an issue. So let's try this again. You're supposed to start dodging when your armor's half, which I forgot to do that. So that's why you'll see me dodge. I thought half health, because I thought I had more time. But, no. Either you start with the red bar, depending on how many pirates there are. And, as you can see, I'll start dodging. There's so many. So yeah, this is the hardest part of the entire glitch, that you're supposed to choose a station that doesn't have as many pirates. This is the closest one I can find. And yeah, there we go. We finally made it in. And we got a badge for that. Now once you're in here, you do the same thing. But this time when we go to the station, there'll be two there. And when I do get enough money, I'll start over to these. And they'll have more damage too, so it'll actually be good to Taurus. And I'll do it with the rockets too, because you can do it with rockets. Is there any good rockets here? Ah, so this one's 500. That'll be yeah, we'll take those. It also works with equipment. It's not worth goods, I can tell you that. But it will work with equipment. Yes, we have that. I am temporarily... I'm actually getting this because of... I feel like I'll need this. And so now the tricky part is getting back. I always find the tricky part. So you do this there is a point where it won't work. Like the money will like be too high, so you try to keep it your money under $1 trillion, or else the game will bug out and you'll be start with zero again, which doesn't really help you. So that's why the limit on the money is $1 trillion. Shields are generating. Pointing arrows. Yeah, you know I like pointing arrows. And let's put those in. And now, they're there. Now the one I will use a lot is the rockets. Those are the ones that use the most because unlike the equipment and stuff like that, they don't take any cargo space. So you'll see me do this until I feel comfortable without dying, because you will lose progress if you die and the glitch is not working. So yeah. So for this next part, I will be quiet. I might pop in and say something, but this next part's going to be the time lapse. So yeah, hope you enjoy. So I will mention this. My goal is, before we're done, is to have the ship that we need, and we'll have like 20 mil or something like that, so we can get the Dark Angel and any other stuff we need to buy. Now, I will want to get the nuke. That's the one I do want, are the nukes, or the lether, whatever one we have, or want. And so yeah, the same thing applies for all equipment. So you can buy, you can sell, and I think this glitch is not. It may seem like cheating, but not really. It's just a glitch in the game. I don't know who found it. I was bored one day and I was watching videos and I was wanting to look up more information on Galaxy and Fire 2. So then we got this glitch that I thought, I didn't believe it at first time, and then I got the station to test it out. And then I was like, oh, it does work. So yeah, that's basically what I did with this. I really didn't think it would work at the beginning. I'm like, I have to do more grinding. This would be crap. But if you see on my other saves, it sort of did work. Like, it actually did work, so I'm happy about that. So we're going to put this in the station, because we're going to grab another one. Now, I will change my good. This is like trading. You try to trade the most expensive thing out there you can get your hands on. And it sort of works that way. And yeah, well, I'm just gonna do this for a extremely long time, and maybe like 20 to 30 minutes, depending on how I feel that day, me today. But yeah, this is gonna be fun because I do have other videos in mind today. I'm planning to do other ones, but this is gonna be one that's I'm gonna put off until later tonight to edit because of how long it takes me to get the audio right and get the screen right, and I periodically stop for this playthrough, so it's in chunks, so I want to make sure I'm recording it, and if I do goof something off, I won't lose a lot. So yeah. Ooh, shredded me for like peanut butter jelly sandwich. So yeah, I hope you enjoy this time lapse, continue of this time lapse, and I'll check back if I have anything else interesting to say. And as you saw right there, we just got one of our first achievements. We're gonna get more of these later on, but yeah, we just got one of our first achievements for jumping 10 jump gates already, and I'll get to that. That's a special lounge, but yeah, we just got more expensive stuff. I will sell all the old stuff first, so that we can still get money, but later on in the game, you'll find that stuff looks useless. And so, not good money maker, but yeah. And so, yeah, that's that was one of the reasons why I wanted to speak right now, so. Yeah.
Uncopyrighted music, boom, boom, doom. If you try to copyright my voice, I'll come after you. Dun, 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 dun. Scratata, scratata, I'm building random crap. Something, something, something red. Oh, look at my dog is dead. I'm building a random house, don't mind me. Look at me, I will shoot you in the knee. Skrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr
and slightly more speed so that we can so that we can have we can do more stuff, more money, more money. Bang, I just did that for that award, so bam, look at that. Okay, I did it, yay. Uncopyrighted music, boom, boom, doom. If you try to copyright my voice, I'll come after you. Dun 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 dun. Scratata, scratata, I'm building random crap. Something, something, something red. Oh, look at my dog is dead. And bam, we got the book school. So, we're almost to the spot where I would finish the video. I want to get at least this because it'll help us until we find a better ship, and it'll also make it this game thing so much easier. Now, after you do get the best ship in the game before the story stops, like, people have done this before. It's not a surprise. People have done this before. Yeah. There's so many more pirates out here. But yeah, people have done this in the past where, like, they don't even do the story for a little bit and they just do all the side quests, which is not surprising to me. But yeah, this is totally fine. The game developers sort of thought this would be like a great idea to do that. Look, they didn't really post you on, like, they didn't like stamp you on a time to say like this, get this done in this time of the day. It's just something that they wanted to do. Another achievement. Boom. Uncopyrighted music. Boom, boom, doom. If you try to copyright my voice, I'll come after you. Dun, 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 dun. Scratata, scratata. I'm building random crap. Something, something, something red. Oh, look at my dog is dead. Ratatatarata. He tara hot tara hot tara he. Hopscotch. I'm building a random house, don't mind me, look at me, I will shoot you in the knee. Skratati, I'm copyrighted music, try to fight me. I will sneak under your radar, and maybe I'll just scree. Ski 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 to the left, ski 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 to the right. Uncopyrighted music, booparatati. Skratati. And we just got another achievement because I went out there with any weapons. But yeah, I'm going to stop it here. Because I want to make other videos today. So I'm just going to stop it here. And I hope you enjoyed this video. I know this one might be a little bit longer, but it might be shorter because of the time lapse that I will do. So we got... a lot of money in this episode. I'll do a little bit more grinding offline, depending on how I feel. And we'll get the other ship before we start, and I'll get a little bit more money. And so, yeah, that's the glitch that's been around for, I think, more than 10 years. It's been around for a while. This glitch has not been patched whatsoever because the game developers of this game, they just don't care about it. They just left it to die and dry. It'd be nice if they made Galaxy Fire 3 was trying to go multiplayer, but they sort of screwed up the gameplay. It's a good game, I can give you that, but it's still crap because you can't do everything you can do in Galaxy Fire 2. It's more of a head-based sort of game, and also it has a lot less... It's more of transactions and... not as much story. Like, this one has good story, has good effort, has the heart there. Galaxy Fire took that and threw it all away. They had completely different systems. This station that I'm at still exists, the Camel Station, but it just isn't the same. It's sort of like every GTA game. Just isn't the same as the last one. So, I hope you enjoyed. And word of today is EMP.